Hi, I am Krishna Kumar, teaching faculty in the Department of Zoology at SKNG Government First Grade College, Gangavati. And here I am doing online classes during the lockdown period. Hi, good morning, dear students. I hope all are fine. I am doing study at home in this lockdown period. This is an online class for you. It may help you. In this session, we will discuss about the 6th semester 6.2 paper, that is Ethology, Evolution and Zoo Geography. In that, the 5th chapter, Zoo Geography, and we will discuss about types of limbs, characteristics of fauna and animal distribution. So let's start. So first of all, we can know the meaning of Zoo Geography. So what is the meaning of zoo geography? It is nothing but a geographical distribution of animals around the world. So what are the types of animals? What are the types of a peculiar fauna? They are distributed over the world. It is called zoo geography. And these are classified into 6 regions. And these regions are called limbs. And in Dr. P.L. Sclater, he was the first map of geographical limbs based on the actual distribution of species. And he classified into 6 regions. They are Nearctic region, Palearctic region, Neotropical region, Ethiopian region, Oriental region, Australian region. And let me study one by one. In this world map, you can easily see the what are the types of limbs, geological limbs. They are divided and distributed in the world map. You can also see the all 6 regions in this map. So we will study one by one. The first region is the Nearctic region, and it includes North America and grasslands. Here in this region, the great variations of climatic conditions like temperatures, and it contains extended from north to south region of America. And the north region, it contains very cold climate, and south region, it contains very hot climate. In the north region, we can see a frozen ice and Greenlands. In case of in south region of North America, we can also see the desert. And this is the Nearctic region is divided into 4 sub-regions. They are California sub-region, Rocky Mountain sub-region, Allegheny sub-region and Canadian sub-region. Let me study one by one. First, California subregion. It comes under North America and Cascade Ranges. It contains nearly 86 families of vertebrates like Aplopridae, vampires, free-tailed bats, and etc. The second one is Rocky Mountain subregion. It includes mountains of East California, and it contains about 107 families of terrestrial vertebrates like goats, haplocerus, dogs, lizards are commonly seen. The third one is Allegheny subregion. It includes rocky mountains of the eastern parts of America. Commonly, the vampire bats, star-nosed moles, opossum, they are fauna of the Allegheny subregions. The fourth one is Canadian subregion. It includes remaining part of North America and Greenlands. And here, bison, glutton, polar bears, Arctic fox, deer are commonly seen in this area. This Nearctic region contains some fauna species like catfishes, pedal fishes and cyprinodonts and like amphibians like buffo, hyla, rana, salamander, and reptiles also present like musk turtle, alligator, opossum, and the birds. The birds contains 39 families of birds, including pelicans, heron, hummingbird, woodpecker, and mammals are also found. 29 families are found in this area, like squirrels, moles, cats, bats, bears, and etc. One is the Palearctic region. This is the very largest region among the six regions of zoological realms. It covers 1,40,00,000 square miles, and it includes Europe, Asia, north of Himalaya, and northern part of Africa. In this region, the temperature is very fluctuations occurs, like in the climate. We can observe the climate here. The temperature is very fluctuations, like cold and to the very hot. Example, the Siberia. It's very cold place in the Palearctic region, and the Sahara. It's very hot place in the Palearctic region. Here you can see the difference of fluctuations of temperature in this region. Due to the high level of fluctuation of temperature, we can see the in the northern side it is very temperate areas, and in eastern Asia you can see a delicious forest. So again, the Palearctic region is divided into four types. So first one, European subregion, Mediterranean subregion, Siberian subregion, and Manchurian subregion. So first, in European subregion, it includes northern and central Europe. It contains about 85 families of vertebrates. Amphibia and reptiles are represented with 6 families each. It contains only one mammalian family called Myogale, and birds like tits, wagtails are in common in this region. The second one is Mediterranean subregion. It includes remaining parts of Europe, Africa, and Arabian portions. It contains about 124 families of terrestrial vertebrates and birds like opupa and pastor. The mammals like elephant, shrimp, civet, and porcupine are present. The third one is Siberian subregion. It includes northern Asia to northern Himalayas. It contains about 94 families of vertebrates. The families like musk deer and yak are present. And the fourth one is Manchurian subregion. It covers Mongolia, Japan, Korea, and Manchuria. Here, the mammals are found like Tibetan langur, great panda, and tufted deer. In the Palearctic region, fishes like paddle fishes, cyprinus, anabas, and suckerfish are present. Amphibians like frogs, buffo, hyla, rhacoporus, salamanders, and reptiles like lizards, turtles, testudo are present. In this region, 37 species of bird families are found, and here parrot is absent. The commonly available of birds are crown, finches, hawks, cocoons, and mammals like camel, deer, wolf, horse, pig are commonly found. The third region is the Neotropical region, and it includes America, West Indies, southern part of Mexico,
And here a very peculiar species are found, and a very rich species are found, and here insectivores are absent. And again, this region is divided into four subregions. The first subdivision is Chilean subregion, and it includes west coast of South America and mountain ranges of Bolivia, Peru and Argentina. It contains three-toed ostrich, it's also called Rhea americana, and the oil birds are common in this area. The second subregion is Brazilian subregion. It includes tropical forest of South America. It is also called evergreen forest because it contains river. Due to the presence of river, it contains high flora and also it contains high fauna. The commonly fauna are blood-sucking bats, alligator, American monkey. The third subregion is Mexican subregion, and here it includes the north of Isthmus of Panama, and this region shows rocky mountains. It showing subtropical conditions. In this region, the Parias mediterraneans are common. And the fourth subregion is Antillean subregion. This subregion contains West Indies islands, and these islands contains mountains. In these subregions, the vertebrate fauna is very poor. In the neotropical regions, fishes like edible fishes, catfishes, lungfishes, they are common in this area. And amphibians like buffo, rana, hyla are common. And in this region, the 14 families of amphibians are present. Then reptiles like alligator, crocodiles are common in this area. And here 5 families lizards are reported. Here, the bird like Rhea americana, it is also called three-toed ostrich, and American ostrich. Flightless birds like Titanum, it's very endangered in this area. 32 families of mammals are available here. Nearly 10 families are very endemic. And here the mammals like deer, squirrel, rabbit, tapirs are common. Fourth region is the Ethiopian region. It includes south of Africa and Madagascar, southern Arabia, and the region of Sahara. It is called the largest desert in the world, and fauna is very rich. About 161 species are found in this region, and it is divided into four sub-regions. They are East African sub-region. East Africa sub-region, it includes tropical Africa and tropical Arabia, and here high temperature deserts are present like Sahara. And animals like giraffe, zebra, camel, ostrich are present. The second subregion is West African subregion. It shows thick forest, River Congo, because due to the heavy rain, the thick forest is formed, and rich of flora is supported for a good fauna, because here availability of very rich flora, a good vegetation, a good fauna species are found. The gorilla, gibbon, great apes, elephants, panthers are common in this area. The third subregion is South African subregion. It contains southern parts of Africa, and it shows a very peculiar fauna like secretary birds, African moles, rats, bandicoots, and South African lungfish. The fourth one is Malagasy subregion. It includes Madagascar and nearby islands. And these are contains a very peculiar species. Here, the chameleons are more popular in this area. In this region, these species are very different from the main land species because here no fresh evolutions are done and they are dissimilar fauna are present when compared to the main lands. And the common fauna are giraffe, zebra, camel, ostrich, gorilla, gibbon, great apes, elephant, panthers, lions in the epithelial regions. The fifth one is the Oriental region. It includes Ceylon, Sumatra, Java, Borneo, Philippines, and eastern and western ghats of India. It varied physical features and it contains a luxuriant forest growth. It contains very thick forest and a very rich fauna species. It is divided into four subregions. The first one is Indian subregion. It includes North India and central part of India. And it is start from Himalayan and aims to the Malabar coast region. And it contains both temperate and tropical conditions. The animals like antelopes, peacock, Indian bison, black elephant are common in this area. The second subregion is Ceylonian subregion. It includes Ceylon and small Indian peninsula. It shows loris, elephant, equus, rat, bandicoots and snakes. The third subregion is Indochina subregion. It includes China, South China, and the animals like gibbons, lemur, rhinoceros, salamanders are present in this area. The fourth subregion is Indo-Malayan subregion. It includes Malayan and surrounding islands. This region is contains 132 family of fauna like gibbon, rhinoceros, broadbills, etc. And here in the Oriental region, the antelopes, peacock, Indian bison, loris, elephant, rat, rhinoceros, salamander, and etc. are present. The sixth one is the Australian region. It includes Australia, New Zealand, New Guinea, and islands of Pacific Ocean. It contains a very peculiar climate. That is, it contains partially tropical and partially temperate regions. And in this region, a luxuriant forest is present and a very peculiar fauna species are found. So it is called Veritable Museum of Lakes. This Australian regions are divided into four regions, sub-regions. First one is Australian sub-region. This includes Australia and Tasmania. This region contains a very peculiar fauna of species and this contains 34 genera of marsupial species. So it is also called home of marsupials. The animals like tailed amphibia, flightless birds like emu are present in this area. The second subregion is Austro-Malayan subregion. It includes Malayan Archipelago Islands, New Guinea, Solomon Islands. The commonly found fauna are fly river, turtles, marsupials, pigeons are present. The third subregion is Polynesian subregion. It includes Polynesian Islands. Here the fauna species is very low and the tooth-billed pigeons are commonly found in this region. The fourth one is New Zealand subregion. It includes New Zealand. Here the snakes are absent And in this region, a one living fossil is found that is called Spinodon. And here, a 34 families of vertebrates are present. Here, the kiwi, it is a flightless bird. It commonly found in the New Zealand. So, kiwi bird, it is the national bird of New Zealand in this region. Okay, here have some tips to prevent the spreading of COVID-19. Wash hand at least 20 seconds. Use soap or sanitizers during washing. Cover coughs and sneezes with tissue paper or mask. Avoid touching your body parts like nose, eyes with unwashed hands. So mainly maintain social distance. By this way, I am ending my this session. I hope you enjoyed this video. Stay at home, be safe. Take care. Thank you.